फ्रेंड्स सब्सक्राइब कीजिए वाईफाई स्टडी चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट एग्जाम वीडियो सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वाईफाई स्टडी चेंजिंग द वे ऑफ लर्निंग प्रेजेंट्स करंट अफेयर 2017 अगस्त सेकंड वीक इन इंग्लिश। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू द सेकंड वीक ऑफ द करंट अफेयर। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट एंड द रेलिवेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन विच इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू फ्रॉम द इंटरनेशनल सेक्शन, ट्रेड एंड बैंकिंग, इकोनॉमिक्स, स्पोर्ट्स, नेशनल, साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, एवरीथिंग वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस वीडियो। एंड फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू सेकंड वीक बिकॉज वी आर लेट एंड आई विल ट्राई दैट फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट टाइम आई विल डेफिनेटली प्रोवाइड यू द नेक्स्ट डे ऑफ द प्रीवियस वीक करंट अफेयर। सो फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब सो दैट वी कैन प्रोवाइड यू मोर वीडियोज, मोर कंटेंट फॉर योर अपकमिंग एग्जाम। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द इंटरनेशनल न्यूज। So let's see the first news. 8th meeting of the regional technical group at the heart of Asia, Istanbul process held in which city? Okay, so there was one meeting which was held and the name of that is Heart of Asia, Istanbul process. Okay, so we need to discuss that where this meeting was held. So 8th meeting of the Asia, Heart of Asia, Istanbul process held in New Delhi. So it was held in New Delhi. So your answer of this question is D. Okay, and what is this Istanbul process? What is this Heart of Asia and Istanbul process? So friends, it is a transatlantic trade agreement. Okay, it is to make business friendly among the heart of Asian countries. Okay, to make more inclusive, comprehensive by expanding them both northwest and southwest to connect South Asia with the Central Asia. Okay, so there was nearby 175 delegates which came from the different countries and participated in this meeting. Okay. And as you know that there is a one Tapi gas pipeline also, it is very important for your exam also. And what does this involve? Tapi, okay, Turkmenistan, then Afghanistan, India, Iran. Okay, so this is all the four nations which belong to this Tapi pipeline. So friends, this is the Heart of Asia. Okay, so these are the countries which belong to the Heart of Asia. If there is a question, then ask that where is the Heart of Asia, which country is located in the Heart of Asia, then these are the countries which is basically at the place of Heart of Asia. So this is the thing that you need to remember. Let's see another one. According to a new study from the Oxford Economics, which one of the following non-Indian city is in the Asia fastest top 5 growing cities list? So according to the Oxford Economics, there are 5 top cities which are considered as the fastest Asian growing countries. So among them, Delhi is the Asia fastest growing cities. Okay, so this is the another question that you need to remember. Delhi is the Asia fastest growing city, and after that there are few Indian cities also. And apart from the Indian cities, there is one city which is Ho Chi Minh. It is the largest metro city in Vietnam. Was the only non-Indian city in the top 5. Okay, so in the top 5 there are 4 from the India and 1 from the outside India, and the city which is not from the India is Ho Chi Minh. So your answer to this question is this one, and it is in Vietnam. Okay, let's see another one. Kyoto Protocol was entered into force in. The Kyoto Protocol was entered into force in. So first of all, you need to understand what is this Kyoto Protocol is all about. Okay, Kyoto Protocol was signed because to reduce the emission of the greenhouse gases. There are few protocol, friends, that you need to remember for your any exam in India. Like Kyoto, as I told you, it is for greenhouse gases. There is the one Rio summit. Okay, it is for biodiversity. There is the one Montreal Protocol. Montreal is in Canada. It is for ozone, reduce the ozone depletion substances. There is the one Ramsar Convention. It is for wetlands. So all these protocols or the conventions are very important for any exam. And if we talk about the Kyoto Protocol, Kyoto city is in Japan, and it was signed in, it was adopted in 1997 actually, and entered into the force in 2005. So they ask you about the, they ask you that Kyoto Protocol was entered into force in. So it was entered into the force in 2005 and it was adopted in 1997. Okay, so these are the two things that you need to remember. 15 BIMSTEC ministerial meeting 2017 held in which city? Okay, so 15 BIMSTEC meeting. So first of all, friends, you need to remember what is this BIMSTEC. Okay, what is the full form of BIMSTEC? It is a Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation. It is an international organization involving a group of countries in South Asia and Southeast Asia. So these are the countries which are considered as a BIMSTEC countries. Okay, sometimes they will ask you that which one of the following is not a BIMSTEC nation, and they will give you the option of Pakistan. So Pakistan is not a BIMSTEC nation. Okay, so all these nations from the two from the Southeast Asia, that is Myanmar, Thailand, and other from the SAARC. आर बिलोंग टू द बिम्स्टेक फैमिली, ओके, एंड दिस वॉज स्टार्टेड इन 1997 एंड न्यू रीजनल ग्रुप वॉज फॉर्म्ड इन बैंकॉक एंड गिवन द नेम बिम्स्टेक. ठीक है, बिम्स्टेक हेडक्वार्टर वॉज इन ढाका बांग्लादेश. And the main objective of BIMSTEC is technological and economic cooperation among South Asia and Southeast Asian nations. Okay, so 15th meeting was held in Kathmandu. So your answer to this question is Kathmandu. Dhaka is the capital of Bangladesh. Thimphu is the capital of Bhutan. And Naypyidaw is the capital of Myanmar. Okay, so these are the few things that you need to remember. Let's see another question. In Kenya, Uhuru Kenyatta has been re-elected as president. Which one of the following country not share its boundary with Kenya? So as you know that Kenya again chose his president which was re-elected. So name of that president is Kenyatta. Okay, so this is very easy that you can easily remember that president of the Kenya is Kenyatta. And the countries which is not the neighboring country of the Kenya is Chad. So your answer is E. Okay. And it is an African nation. It is a founder member of East African Community also. What capital of Kenya is Nairobi. Okay, and official language is English and Swahili. And currency is shilling. And you can see the map of the Kenya. There are few nations like Sudan, Ethiopia, Somalia, Uganda, Tanzania. These are the nations which are the neighbor of the Kenya. And Chad is not among them. So your answer is E. Okay, and you don't need to confuse about the Lake Victoria also. If they will ask you about the Great Victoria Desert. Okay, so this Great Victoria Desert is in Australia. If they will ask you about the Lake Victoria, then this is in Africa. Okay, this is the Lake Victoria. Okay, let's see another question. In October, with which country India will hold a mega war game? So India Russia to hold mega war game in October, and this is in what is this mega war game? In this mega war game involves all the three armies, that is Army, Navy, Air Force, for the first time to further ramp up military ties. So exercise, what is the name of exercise between India and Russia? Indra, okay, which will be held in October and will primarily focus on achieving coordination between the forces of two countries in a tri-service integrated theater command scenario. And it will be the first time India will participate in a tri-service exercise with a foreign country with such a large-scale participation by the Navy, Army and Air Force. So your answer of this question is Russia. E is your answer. And what is the capital of Russia? Moscow is the capital of the Russia. What is the currency? Ruble. Russian ruble is the currency of the Russia. And who is the president? Vladimir Putin is the president. You can see in this picture. And who is the PM right now? Dmitry Medvedev is the PM of the Russia. India Asia Youth Summit to be held in which city? So India Asian Youth Summit was held in one of our city and it was held in Bhopal. Okay, so the event been organized by the Foreign Ministry, Madhya Pradesh Government and India Foundation, and it will mark the 25th anniversary of the Asian India Dialogue Partnership in the ongoing year and also the commemorate year theme of shared values, common destiny. Okay, Madhya Pradesh has been chosen for this event as a Sachi Stupa has strengthened the state cultural affliction with the Asian countries. And it is a part of the East Asia policy of the Narendra Modi government. Okay, so you need to remember the Asian countries also. So these are the Asian nations you need to remember. In this, here is the India and this is the, from there. Okay, Myanmar starts. After that, this is the Thailand, then this is the Laos, then this is the Vietnam. Okay, then here it is Cambodia, then it is Philippines. Okay, then this is Malaysia, then this is Singapore, this is Indonesia, this is Cambodia. Okay, this is Cambodia and this is Brunei, then Philippines, Laos. So these are the nations of the Asian. Recently, which one of the following country has been declared polio free by the WHO? So United Nations World WHO said that it had not recorded any case of the polio disease in Somalia in the last 3 years, declaring the country polio free. Okay, so from the last 3 years, Somalia didn't witness any case and because of that, Somalia was declared polio free. So the answer is D. So WHO did a great job in these diseases, friends, as you see, you can see in 1988 there are a lot more cases of polio, and if you go to the 2016 there are only few nations and few cases were reported of the पोलियो डिजीज़, ओके, एंड दिस पोलियो डिजीज़ इज कॉज्ड बाय द पोलियो वायरस, ओके, इन विच देर इज़ ए मसल वीकनेस कम्स एंड देर इज़ ए इनएबिलिटी टू मूव. नाउ लेट्स सी सर नेशनल क्वेश्चंस. Let's see another question. Under which initiative Niti Aayog announces partnership with 6 states to transform health and education sector? Okay, so first of all, you need to understand and you need to remember few things from the Niti Aayog. Okay, this is a very important body. SSC asked in 2017 one question from the Niti Aayog. Okay, and it was very predictive. I told in the GK class also. So if we talk about the Niti Aayog, then this organization was made in 2015, 1st January 2015. And the preceding organization was Planning Commission. Headquarter it is in New Delhi, and there are few person which are very important for your exam, that like chairman, who is the chairman, PM is the chairman of the Niti Aayog, who is the vice chairman. Previously Arvind Pangalia was the vice chairman, and right now Rajiv Kumar is the chairman, vice chairman of this organization. And if we talk about the CEO, Abhitabh Kant is the CEO of this organization, and there are three members also like Ramesh Chand, VK Saraswat and Bibek Debroy. Okay, so if we talk about this question, then Niti Aayog announces partnership with the 6 states to transform health and education sector, and they started 7 initiative to handhold them and transfer their health sector. Okay, so your answer of this question is E, and this mission was started to transform the health sector and the education sector. So they partnership with the 6 states. Okay, they're like Uttar Pradesh, Assam, Karnataka, and there are 3 different states also. Okay, you do not need to remember the name of the states, but you need to remember the scheme, initiative, that is SAAT. Which one of the following state has stopped in sanitation survey released by the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation? So this is a ranking about the sanitation work. In among all these 29 states of the nation, Kerala, Haryana top sanitation survey. So Kerala and Haryana, in this option, there is one Kerala. Okay, so your answer is Kerala. According to the survey, almost all the rural households in Kerala and Haryana had access to a toilet. So we are talking about a toilet, that you should have to make a toilet. This is an initiative by the Government of India, and the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation released the finding of survey of 1.4 lakh rural households. If we talk about the Northeast states, then Sikkim, Manipur, Nagaland have 95% rural household covered by toilets, while Himachal and Uttarakhand also performed very well by covering 90% toilet coverage of the rural households. But the BJP ruled Uttar Pradesh and NDA ruled Bihar was among the worst performing in the terms of rural sanitation. Bihar recorded only 30% and UP 37%. Okay. India is deploying fence system at park border, which is developed by. So this is a very good news for each and every citizen of the society, because India is infected by the terrorism, and currently what India is doing, they shared their problem with the Israel, and Israel started to help them with a fence system. Okay, Israel fence system at park border, you can see in this news. So your answer of this question is B. And okay, the India is deploying along its volatile border with Pakistan a smart Israel developed fencing system having a quick response team mechanism which strike when the CCTV powered control room detects an infiltration attempt. And BSF is implementing an ambitious project called the CIBMS. Okay, as a part of Narendra Modi government plan to completely seal the Indo-Pak and Indo-Bangladesh border in the next few years. Which one of the following ministry launches live Twitter wall on Bharat Kevir? This is also an important question, because Home Minister launches live Twitter wall on Bharat Ke Veer, and it is to promote the education of all those martyrs which sacrificed their lives for the country in the line of duty. Okay, so CAAF, as you know that there are a lot more families from the different martyrs of our nation, and this is a portal facilitates online donation directly to the families of CAPF martyr who sacrificed their lives for the country in the line of duty. And the head of this campaign is Akshay Kumar. Okay. Bharat Ke Veer portal was launched by Union Home Minister and Akshay Kumar on April 9, 2017. So your answer of this question is Home Affairs. Which one of the following authority launches India's first online course on infusion therapy for nurses? So Infusion Nurses Society, INS, is a global authority in infusion therapy, launched India's first online course on infusion therapy for nurses, under which it aims to train over 3,000 nurses in the vital medical procedure. So your answer to this question is B. First of all, Infusion Nurses Society is a global authority in infusion therapy. Among the initiative which will boost nurses even in the rural parts of India. Okay, this is a must required service. Okay, that there should be the healthcare society, there should be some nurses, there should be some doctors. Okay, so because of that, they started this operation. Feed Day Puducherry Festival is held in association with which from the following institution? So Feed Day Puducherry begins, okay, in the Puducherry, and artists from the 11 state and the Union Territory of Puducherry take part in this festival, 3-day inaugural cultural festival. Department of Arts and Art and Culture said that the troops from the states will present prestigious or the program or different programs in urban and rural areas during the 3-day. And the festival is held in the association with the South Zone Cultural Center, Thanjavur. So your answer to this question is C. It was held with the help of South Zone Cultural Center, Thanjavur. Okay. And what you also need to remember that Puducherry was previously a part of French territory. Which one of the following government has launched Namo Yuva Rojgar Kendra? So Pradhan Mantri Namo Yojana Namo Yuva Rojgar Kendra was started by the Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, launched this scheme in Maharashtra. Okay, for farmers they should have to market on wheels, which aim at delivering fresh farm fresh organic produce at reasonable price. Okay, so a total of 125 farmers to home delivery vans will be toured the city to sell the product. The vegetables sold in the mobile van will be 25% lower than the average market rate. And this initiative started to generate jobs for uneducated youth and women. Okay, so your answer of this question is Maharashtra. Maharashtra started this scheme. Now let's see some finance question. Let's see the first question from the finance sector. Which state government raised $270 million from the Green Climate Fund, which will be invested in integrated watershed programs such as Jal Yukt Shivar Yojana? Okay, so one of our government raised $270 million from the Green Climate Fund. And what is this Green Climate Fund? It is a new fund under the United Nations, and it is guided by the principle and provision of the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. Okay, so Maharashtra government raised $270 million from Green Climate Fund. So your answer to this question is C, first of all. Okay, and this fund will be taken because of the watershed program such as Jal Yukt Shivar Yojana, and they target that up to the 2020, okay, they want to close the gap between the water demand and supply. Okay, so this is the main aim of this scheme. Which one of the following state bank launches instant credit card? So ICICI Bank launches instant credit card, okay, and enabling as saving account customers to get a credit card instantly in a completely digital and paperless manner. So your answer of this question is ICICI Bank. IDFC Bank partners with which digital payment bank application for e-payment solution? So first of all, we need to understand the IDFC Bank, what is this full form and everything about it. So the full form of IDFC is Infrastructure Development Finance Company. It is an Indian banking company with its headquarters is in Mumbai. Okay, and this bank started operation on 2015 and received a universal banking license from the RBI in 2015 also itself. Okay. And it was listed in BSE and NSE also. So your answer to this question is Zeta. They partnered with the Zeta for e-payment solution. SEBI entered into a pact with Dash to promote technical assistance and facilitate cross-border cooperation in the area of security regulation. So SEBI tied up with the SEO of Iran for technical assistance. Okay, so SEO of Iran. So your answer to this question is D. Okay, and this one... What this assistance was taken to facilitate cross-border cooperation in the field of security regulation, and the pact would facilitate mutual assistance, contribute towards efficient performance of the supervisory function, and enable effective enforcement of the law and regulation governing the security markets. Okay, and who is the chairman of the right now? Chairman or the chief of SEBI, Ajay Tyagi is the chief of it, and it was founded in 1992 and headquarters in Mumbai, and chairman is Ajay Tyagi of the SEBI. Which one of the following entity has launched a lending platform for digital currency in India? Okay, so there is one entity which is trying to make a lending platform for digital currencies, and the entity which did this was BitBay to launch trading platform for digital currency in India. There are different digital currency like Bitcoin, Litecoin, Ether, Lisk, Monero, Dash, okay, Game Credit. So these all are belong to the digital currency. Okay, and your answer of this question is BitBay. C is your answer. ई शक्ति इज अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एंटिटीज. सो ई शक्ति इज अ इनिशिएटिव ऑफ द पायलट प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ नाबार्ड. एंड व्हाट इज इज नाबार्ड? नाबार्ड इज नेशनल रूरल बैंक फॉर एग्रीकल्चर डेवलपमेंट. ओके, रूरल डेवलपमेंट, नेशनल बैंक फॉर एग्रीकल्चर एंड रूरल डेवलपमेंट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ नाबार्ड. एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द नाबार्ड इज टू प्रोवाइड लोन्स टू द स्मॉल एंड फाइनेंस स्मॉल एंड मीडियम स्केल इंडस्ट्रीज. इट वॉज स्टार्टेड इन 1982 ऑन द रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ शिवा रमन कमिटी. ओके, दीज फोर लाइन्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. हेड क्वार्टर इज इन चेन्नई. ओके, एंड हु इज द हेड ऑफ दिस? चीफ ऑफ दिस, अजय त्यागी इज द चीफ ऑफ दिस. दीज आर द फ्यू इन्फॉर्मेशन विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू. एंड योर आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज नाबार्ड. विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग बैंक भारत क्यू आर एंड भारत बिल पेमेंट सिस्टम. ओके, लॉन्च्ड विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग बैंक लॉन्च्ड भारत क्यू आर एंड भारत बिल पेमेंट सिस्टम. सो कैनरा बैंक लॉन्चेस अ टू न्यू डिजिटल सर्विसेज. वन इज भारत बिल पेमेंट सर्विस एंड सेकेंड इज द सेकेंड इज द भारत क्यू आर. सो योर आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ई. एंड वॉट, लेट्स सी अबाउट सम मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट कैनरा बैंक. इट वॉज स्टार्ट इन 1969, हेड क्वार्टर इन बैंगलुरु. चेयरमैन इज श्री टी एन मनोरथन एंड एम डी एंड सी ई ओ इज श्री राकेश शर्मा. नाउ लेट्स सी सम साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी क्वेश्चंस. विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंपनी विल लॉन्च अ सुपर कंप्यूटर इन टू स्पेस ऑन द स्पेस एक्स ड्रैगन एयरक्राफ्ट. ओके, सो देयर इज अ वन कंपनी विच सेड दैट दे विल गोइंग टू लॉन्च अ सुपर कंप्यूटर इन टू द स्पेस. ओके, ऑन द स्पेस एक्स ड्रैगन स्पेस क्राफ्ट. सो लेट्स सी द न्यूज. द इंटरनेशनल स्पेस स्टेशन इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू गेट इट्स फर्स्ट सुपर कंप्यूटर नेक्स्ट वीक. एच पी एंटरप्राइज विल लॉन्च ए सुपर कंप्यूटर इन टू स्पेस ऑन स्पेस एक्स ड्रैगन स्पेस क्राफ्ट. सो योर आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन इज एच पी. ओके, ए इज योर आंसर. एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द इंटरनेशनल स्पेस स्टेशन. ओके, इट इज अ स्पेस स्टेशन फॉर अ हैबिटेबल आर्टिफिशियल सेटेलाइट इन लो अर्थ ऑर्बिट. द फर्स्ट कंपोनेंट लॉन्च इन टू ऑर्बिट इन 1998 ऑफ द ISS. ओके, एंड इट इज नाउ द ह्यूमन लार्जेस्ट बॉडी इन द लो अर्थ ऑर्बिट एंड कैन ऑफन बी सीन विद द नेकेड आइज फ्रॉम अर्थ ऑल्सो. And the different components of the ISS is pressurized modules, external trusses, solar array and other components. Okay, and the ISS component has been launched by Russian Proton and Soyuz rocket and American space shuttle. Okay, and there is one laboratory also in which there is a different experiment going on about the different diseases. Now let's see some appointments question. Who among the following will be the next Chief Justice of India? Another very important question, because as you know that our current Chief Justice J.S. Kher will be retired on 27th of this month, and Justice Mishra is the senior most judge of the Supreme Court after Justice Kher, so he will be going to appointed as the next Chief Justice of India. So your answer of this question is Deepak Mishra. Okay, and he will be the 45th Chief Justice of India, and he will be appointed by the President of India. Okay, and what is the retiring age of the Chief Justice? 65 year of age, and in High Court the judges are retired on 62 year of age. These are the information you need to remember. Who among the following appointed as the MD of the Export Import Bank of India, also known as Exim Bank? So David Rajkuena appointed as the MD of the Exim Bank. So your answer to this question is E. And if you talk about the Exim Bank, and it is a premier export finance institution in India, established in 1982. It was established in 1982. Okay, under the Export Import Act of India 1981. And since its inception, Exim Bank of India has been both a catalyst and a key player in the promotion of cross-border trade and investment. Who among the following is appointed as the chairman of CBFC? Another very good news for the Bollywood, because new chairman of the CBFC is Prasoon Joshi, who is very, very well known in the Bollywood and is a very good lyricist also. So he became chairman of the Central Board of Film Certification, okay, for the period of 3 years. Mr. Joshi has replaced former chairman Pahalaj Nihalani. Okay, and let's see something about the CFFC. It is a statutory body under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, regulating the public exhibition of films under the provision of the Cinematography Act. And the board consists of non-official members and a chairman, all of whom are appointed by the central government. And its headquarters is in Mumbai. And any film can be publicly exhibited in the country only after they have been certified by it. Let's see some awards question. Who among the following will be honored with the Asia Society 2017 Asia Game Changer Award? Okay, so Dev Patel to be honored with the Asia Society Game Changer Award. So your answer is E. And Aga Khan, okay, the Asia Game Changer Lifetime Achievement Award will be given to Aga Khan. He is a founder of Aga Khan Development Network by using philanthropy to lift millions of Asia's most vulnerable. Okay, Let's see another question. Who among the following is awarded with the Hugo Award for the Best Novel 2017 for her work, The Obsolete Gate? Okay, Obsolete Gate. So, N.K. Jemisin got this award. N.K. Jemisin. So, your answer is C. Okay, this Hugo Award for Best Novel 2017 was given to J.K. Jemisin. She is an American specular fiction writer for her work, The Obelisk Gate. Let's say sports question. Who among the following won the men 400 meter event title and retained his title in the World Athletic Championship, London? Okay, in World Athletic Championship, Olympic champion Wendy Van. So your answer to this question is Wendy Van. C is your answer. Won the 400 meter event and retained his title in London. The world record holder, South African Nairik, clocked 43.99 seconds to finish at the top of podium. Okay, and so this is the important information you need to remember, that in the World Athletic Championship 400 meter men's category, okay, when won this award. Which one of the following city will host 2028 Olympic Games? So friends, in this story there are two things that you need to remember. In fact, three things. 2020 Olympic will be going to held in Tokyo, 2024 Paris, and 2028 Los Angeles. All these three Olympics are very important for exam. Okay, and let's see some information about the Olympics. Modern Olympic Games were held in Athens, Greece in 1896. The official symbol of the modern games is five interlocking colored rings representing the continents of the world. Motto is the Citrus Artis Fortis, that is faster, higher and stronger, and the present is the Thomas Bake. Okay, and your answer to this question is the C. Which one of the following sector bagged a bronze medal at the Asia Shotgun Championship 2017 in Astana? Okay, so recently Asia Shotgun Championship was held, and there are few shooter which won some medals out there. So first of all, you need to remember Maheshwari Chauhan, who bagged a bronze medal at the Asia Shotgun Championship. So your answer is Maheshwari Chauhan. Okay, and there are few different person from the different part of the country also won this, like Miraj Rashmi pair bagged gold at the Asia Shotgun Championship. So A is your answer, who won the gold medal. Apart from it, there are Ankur Mittal also, who earlier won a gold in the men double trap and had also helped India back the team gold in the event. Kayan Chennai won a bronze in the men's trap. So Chennai won the bronze medal in the men's trap and participate. Shreyas Singh to claim the mixed team bronze also. Okay, let's see another question. In which country the Under 19 Cricket World Cup will be held? So if we talk about the Under 19 Cricket World Cup, Asia Cup, we are not talking about the Cricket World Cup, we are talking about the Cricket Asia Cup. Okay, previously it was won by India, and in 2017 this will be going to held in Malaysia. Okay, previously it was going to held in India, but because of the objection of the Pakistan, it was shifted to Malaysia. Okay. So friends, let's see another question. World Athletic Championship held in which city? So this is a very important question, friends, because as you know that Usain Bolt and Mohammed Farah bid farewell. Okay, so in World Athletic Championship, sprint superstar Usain Bolt could not finish the last race of his illustrious career in London. Okay, so first of all, this championship was held in London. Okay, and Bolt was on a track of 4x100m final, anchoring one last time for his country Jamaica. The event was won by the host Great Britain. So you need to understand, remember, first of all, the 4x100m final was won by Great Britain, and another shocking farewell was that of Mohammed Farah, the greatest distance runner, as he finished second place in the 5000m event. Okay, if they will ask you about the gold medal, then Usain Bolt won nearby 8 Olympic gold medals in his entire lifespan, and Mohammed Farah won 4 Olympic gold medals. Okay, this is the thing that you need to remember. Let's see another question. Okay, now we are going to see the questions from the this section. Who among the following known as the Pakistan Mother Teresa? So Pakistan Mother Teresa, Dr. Ruth died. So Dr. Ruth, a German doctor popularly known as the Pakistan Mother Teresa, was dedicated her life to eradicate leprosy in the country, died. She was 87. So your answer of this question is D. Okay, so Dr. Pifu first visited Pakistan in 1960 and was so touched by the plight of the leprosy victim that she decided to stay far out in the country to treat them. Okay, and she also started a foundation in the Karachi also. And if we talk about the leprosy, then another name of the leprosy is known as Hansen disease. This is the important thing that you need to remember. Hansen disease, also known as leprosy. It is a long-term infection caused by the bacterium Mycobacterium leprosy. Okay, and it is normally spread between the people. This is thought to occur through a cough or contact with the fluid from the nose of an infected person. And normally, this leprosy occurs more commonly among those living in the poverty line. Okay, so let's see another one. Recently, Shobha Sen has died. She belongs to which one of the following field? So, theater personality Shobha Sen died. So, your answer of this question is A. Shobha Sen, veteran theater personality and wife of late thespian Utpal Dutt, passed away. And what is the meaning of thespian? Thespian means a person who do acting or that drama. Let's see the questions from the book section. Who among the following is the author of the book title Left, Right and Center, The Idea of India? So, in this book, Left, Right and Center, the author tell you about the different cultures of the nation, languages, tradition, custom, controversies. And a very famous TV journalist, Nidhi Rajdhan, is the author of this book. So, the answer of this question is Nidhi. Okay, so in this, there are 12 chapters that give insight into the variety of significant issues, and each chapter critically analyses various facts of India. Okay, so friends, these are the important questions from the second week of the August, and hope you like it and you will subscribe us. And there are different questions that will definitely going to come in your upcoming exam from this part of the story. So, friends, thank you and all the best.